Got the man with the plan right here. Bring it swagger, the man right here. Leaving enough fun, sipping on beer. Yeah, clap for me, man right here. Got the man with the plan right here. Bring it swagger, the man right here. Leaving enough fun, sipping on beer. Yeah, clap for me, man right here.
Hi dear student, welcome to my channel. So in this slot, we're going to study the forecast question for SPM 2020 chemistry paper. And I will focus on paper 3 first, then in the slot 2, I will focus on paper 2. Alright, so the first targeted for section A, which carries 33 marks, is heat of neutralization. And my second targeted question for paper 3 is heat of displacement. And the third targeted question will be heat of neutralization process, rate of reaction, temperature factor, catalyst factor, and the design for experiment. Design experiment for paper section B, which carries 17 marks, will be electrolysis. Electrolysis factor, concentration of factor affect the selectively discharge of product at anode. And also we will focus on the coagulation of latex, heat of combustion, and the factor 1 and factor 3, which is a factor type of electrode versus the position of ion again in the electrolysis process. Alright, we'll start with the first point, first targeted question, which is heat of neutralization. Okay, we try to check the question. This is a really odd topic, so I want students to really focus on this part. Okay, we have two sets. Set 1 is given potassium hydroxide solution reacted with nitric acid. Okay, the potassium hydroxide is a strong alkali and nitric acid is strong acid, and the heat of neutralization produced for this reaction will be higher. And we try to check set 2. In set 2, we have potassium hydroxide, strong alkali, reacted with ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid is weak acid. And the heat of neutralization produced for this reaction will be lower. Alright, okay, so we check the initial temperature of potassium hydroxide. When here given 1 dp decimal point, the student must fill the final temperature and temperature change with 1 decimal point. And we check the final temperature of this reaction, set 1, will be 40.0. So I'll put here 40.0 degrees Celsius. And the temperature change, we minus final temperature with initial temperature, we will get 12.0 degrees Celsius. Alright, okay, we check for set 2. The set 2, the initial temperature given is 28 degrees Celsius with 1 decimal point, and we'll go for final temperature. Final temperature, this is 35, and now we have 36, 37, 38. So I'll put here 38.0 degrees Celsius, and the temperature change is 10.0 degrees Celsius. Again, then I already score, student already score 3 marks for this reaction. And now we try to write down the hypothesis in this experiment. The hypothesis will be the heat of neutralization. Heat of neutralization in reaction between strong acid react with strong alkali, okay, is higher than the heat of neutralization, than the heat of neutralization in reaction between strong alkali react with weak acid. So I already score 3 marks. And we try to check the manipulated variable. The manipulated variable will be the factor that changed purposely in this experiment. We use set 1, we use nitric acid. Set 2, we use ethanoic acid. That will be type of acid used. Type of acid. Type of acid used. All student can straight away name the acid, which is nitric acid and ethanoic acid. And the responding variable, the aim of this experiment to measure the heat of neutralization. And the constant variable for this experiment, we can put the initial temperature for set 1 and set 2 remains the same, which is 28 degrees Celsius. So I'll put initial temperature of potassium hydroxide solution, or we can put type of alkali use. We use sodium hydroxide for both reaction. And question number 3, construct a table. So student required to do table with the title, again with the unit at the title. Okay, construct a table that can use to record the data from both experiment. So I try to put set 1, set 2. The first title will be initial temperature of potassium hydroxide, final temperature of sodium mixture, and the temperature change with this theta. And I'll try to fill up all the finding in the table. So this will be 28.0, 28.0. And here I got 40.0, and the temperature change will be 12.0. So this is 38.0, the temperature change is 10.0. And we go for question number four, state 3 observation that could be obtained in set 2 other than temperature change. That means students cannot write the temperature change for set 1 is higher than set 2. So in set 2, we check. In set 2, we have potassium hydroxide reacted with ethanoic acid. And we try to check what are the possible observation that we can check. We can get from set 2. So this is set 2. Okay, in set 2, what we will do, we will put the thermometer. All right, and here we will pour potassium hydroxide solution and we will add ethanoic acid. All neutralization reaction is an exothermic reaction. All right, exothermic reaction. Therefore, we will check the thermometer reading will increases. This is our first observation. And the second observation, when we will touch the polystyrene cup. When we touch the polystyrene cup, we will feel warmer when touch the polystyrene cup. Right, okay, so we go for third observation. We try to write the equation, ethanoic acid reacted with potassium hydroxide, we will get a potassium ethanoate. CH3COO plus water will be produced. And this reaction is a neutralization. When acid react with alkali, we will get a salt plus water. This salt is a colorless solution. So the third observation, a colorless solution will form. Alright, okay, so we go for fourth observation. And this vinegar as ethanoic acid as vinegar smell, and at the end of the reaction the vinegar smell will disappear. So we can put vinegar smell will disappear. Right, so we have total 4 observation. We need to write only 3 in this question number 4. So I'll go for first question is observation, the thermometer reading increases. The second observation will be feels warmer when touch the polystyrene cup. And the third observation will be a colorless solution is formed. All right, okay, cool. So we go for fifth question. State the inference on the base on the answer in question number 4. So we try to check set 2. We use potassium hydroxide reacted with ethanoic acid, and student must write this one first. The reaction between ether noric acid. The reaction between ether noric acid react with potassium hydroxide. Potassium hydroxide, and we already know this is exothermic reaction, so release it to surrounding. Therefore, the thermometer reading and also we will feel warmer when touch the plastic cup, and the thermometer reading will increases. All right. Okay. So we go for question number 6. The question number 6 will involve with calculation, and we need to find the heat of neutralization between set 1 and set 2. And set 1 I already do for you guys, and we try to do for set 2. We need to find the number of mole. We will use mv over 1000, and we check the molarity for set 2. The set 2, the molarity or volume of potassium hydroxide is v 25, molarity is 2.0. here also the ethanoic acid, the volume and molarity is same. Therefore, I apply here 2.0 times 25 divide 1000, I will get 0.05 mole. Follow the decimal point same with the ethanoic acid in the set 2. And the third one, second priority step will be, we need to find heat change mc theta. The total volume is 25 plus 25 times with 4.2, the specific heat capacity, and the temperature change that we obtain is 10.0, and we try to find the calculate answer. We need to convert into kilojoule, and I will get 2.10 kilojoule. All right, and now we go for heat of neutralization, the Q divide with N, so we try to put 2.10 kilojoule divide with 0.05 mole, so I will get the answer negative. If exothermic, we must put it of the reaction negative symbol, negative 42.0 kilojoule per mole. Right? Okay, I'll go for question number seven. State the relationship between type of acid. We have two type of acid. Number one, strong acid. Number two is weak acid. And the value of heat of neutralization obtained in this experiment. Strong acid ionizes completely, produce high concentration of hydrogen ion, while weak acid ionizes partially in water, produce lower concentration of hydrogen ion. Some weak acid molecules still, weak acids are substance still exists as molecule. Therefore, the heat release during neutralization will absorb, some of the heat release will absorb to further ionize the molecules of acid. Okay, so how to answer this question? Strong acid and strong alkali will produce higher heat of neutralization compared to weak acid and strong alkali. This is because weak acid ionizes partially, therefore some of the heat is released is used to further ionize the molecule. So I already scored 3 marks, and we try to check how to do operational definition. If student want to do operational definition, OD stand for what observe plus what done, and we try to check what observe and what done. So I do one reaction, so here polystyrene cup, I put the thermometer. Alright, so here we place as alkali. Okay, we need to pour acid. Always remember the heat of neutralization. The general definition in heat of neutralization, we must add 1 mole of water molecule. So we check what observe in this experiment, what observe is thermometer reading increases. So the answer, the thermometer reading increases or the temperature rises. What done in this experiment? So we need to start with when acid is added to alkali. When acid is added to alkali, and to obtain or to produce, take this one, we have to add here, to produce one mole of water molecules is heat of neutralization. So I already do the operational definition, so we try to answer here. Okay, so give operational definition for the heat of neutralization, the thermo meter reading increases when acid is added to alkali to produce one mole of water molecules. Okay, 1 mole of water molecules is it of neutralization. And now we try to go for question number 9. Question number 9 is a prediction. When prediction, we have to check the we have to read the question based on the temperature in set 2. Predict the temperature change if the potassium hydroxide is replaced by ammonia solution. Ammonia solution is a weak alkali, so what will happen? We try to check here. Okay, so I put here set one, we take nitric acid reacted with potassium hydroxide. Both is strong acid and strong alkali respectively, so their temperature change is 12 degrees Celsius. Alright, so we go for set two. I take our potassium hydroxide. Here, ethanoic acid reacted with potassium hydroxide. One is weak alkali acid. Sorry, another one strong alkali. The temperature change is 10.0 degrees Celsius. I'll go for set three, which is prediction. Ethanoic acid reacted with ammonia solution. The temperature change from year to year drop 2 degrees Celsius, from year to year minus 2 degrees Celsius, which is 8.0 degrees Celsius. So the answer will be 8.0 degrees Celsius. All right. Okay, and the last question number 10. Okay, the experiment is repeated by using acid W, acid X, Y and Z with a potassium hydroxide. The value of it of neutralization of this acid given in the table. So always remember, the strong acid will carry value of 56.6 above. All right, so this is our strong acid, and this is our weak acid. All right, this is weak acid, this is weak acid. Therefore, put your acid, strong acid must do complete table, weak acid W, Y and Z. Alright, so this is my first forecast question for SPM 2020. And I'll go for second targeted question, which is heat of displacement. The heat of displacement already given in my module. So those one, my module can text me, or can send the module to the students. Alright, so check heat of neutralization. Heat of neutralization, the experiment 1, magnesium reacted with copper 2 nitrate solution. Magnesium is more electropositive metal, therefore the temperature change will be higher. Alright, and the set 2 will be is added with lead powder. So here Pb reacted with copper 2 nitrate solution, and the temperature change for experiment 2 will be lower than the experiment 1. So here we can check the temperature reading. So student need to require to find the reading. So this is 63.0. So here I got 349.0. all right and how to construct a table to construct the initial and highest temperature of the mixture and the temperature change. The answer is here. All right. Okay, and now we try to do the hypothesis. The hypothesis in this experiment, when a more electropositive metal is added to copper 2 nitrate. So this metal, if more electropositive, we added to copper 2 nitrate solution, the temperature change or the heat of displacement is higher. And if let's say this metal is less electropositive, we added to copper 2 nitrate solution, the temperature change will be lower. So the hypothesis will be, when a more electropositive metal is added to copper 2 nitrate solution, the heat of displacement produced is higher. The more the electropositive metal gives the higher heat of neutralization when react with copper 2 nitrate solution. And we check the manipulated variable type of metal or magnesium and lead. Type of metal and magnesium or lead. So here is your manipulated variable. The it of displacement is here, the responding variable, and the constant variable will be copper 2 nitrate solution. Check question number D. Based on experiment 1, we need to determine the two observations. So experiment 1 will be magnesium reacted with copper 2 nitrate solution. We will get a magnesium nitrate solution, which is colorless solution, and a brown color solid will deposited. Alright, so the first point will be the 1-2 observation. The first point always state the color of the solid deposited. A brown solid is deposited, and the intensity of blue color solution, this is blue color solution, okay, will turn to colorless. Alright, when turn to colorless. So next, give inference for the answer in question D. A brown solid form when shows the copper 2 ions has been reduced to copper atoms. Alright, and the second inference will be the intensity of blue color of copper 2 sulfate solution turns colorless shows the concentration of copper 2 ions decreases and magnesium ions form. And operational definition for it of neutralization, what done OD will be what observed plus what done. Alright, so the temperature increases will be what observed. Alright, what observed, and what done will be the copper 2 sulfate solution. This is the one. 1 mole of copper is displaced from copper 2 sulfate solution when more electropositive metal is added. Alright, so this is our operational definition. And we try to check this next question is a calculation. As a calculation, calculate the heat release when copper 2 copper displaced by magnesium metal. So we try to check heat change. The formula to calculate heat change will be Q equals to mc theta. The total volume of the solution is 50 cm³, so I'll use 50 cm³. The 4.2, the temperature change is 35.0 degrees Celsius, then I got 7.35 kilojoule. And I tried to calculate the number of mole, the volume, the molarity is 1.0 mole dm negative 3, and volume is 50 cm³. So once apply, I got this process answer. And finally, we go for heat of displacement. The heat of displacement, okay, it will carry negative symbol. Why? Because the temperature of the final temperature increases. When final temperature increases, odd means exothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction, the heat of the reaction will carry negative symbol. Everything negative in our life, arrow going down. How to fix the situation? So we have to turn right, and before that all left. So this is the energy level diagram that we need to draw. All right can okay, so we go for our next question. List of the chemicals is dissolved in the distilled water as shown for flow. And always remember, strong alkali, strong acid always is under exothermic. So here alkali sodium hydroxide will be exo. Ammonium nitrate is used in cold pack ammonium, so this will be endo. Anhydrous copper 2 sulfate under exothermic reaction. Potassium hydroxide is a base, so base will be under exothermic reaction. So I'll try to put the answer. So we have to construct, classify, must do table and divider. So I put here exothermic reaction, endothermic reaction, potassium oxide, and anhydrous copper 2 sulfate, and the endothermic will be ammonium nitrate. So I already scored 33 marks in this question. And my third targeted question will be so we also need to draw energy level diagram. When the heat of the reaction carries negative symbol, always remember arrow should going down. Alright, everything happen in our life is negative. When negative going down, and how to fix this situation, you have to turn right. So I'll turn right, and before that this will be turn left. So I write the energy level diagram. You can use ionic equation or you can use a chemical equation. Alright, okay, so we need to predict based on this experiment, predict the heat of displacement by copper, by zinc. If let's say magnesium by copper to sulfate solution. Copper to sulfate solution, the heat of displacement that we obtain is here, is negative 147 kilojoule per mole. So I put here negative 147.0 kilojoule. This is the heat of neutralization we obtain. And we need to predict for zinc reacted with copper to nitrate solution. For zinc reacted with copper to nitrate solution, the value should be less because magnesium is more electropositive than zinc. So I'll try to put less than this value. I can take from the range of 88.2 until 47, less than 47, okay, 0.0 degrees Celsius. So in this case, I'll take negative 117.65 kilojoule per mole. Alright, okay, what is the operational definition for heat of displacement? The temperature increases. This is what observed when one mole of metal. So this one we already learned just now. So I just want to show you the how to draw energy level diagram. Alright, so my third targeted question will be titration. So we try to check the questions and titration when burette reading given. Always remember when burette reading given, we must put 2 decimal points. So the answer like this, okay? Student, just text me, just message me in the comment box. I will send the module together with the answer to y'all, okay? Thank you, Anya. So we go for this one, the final burette reading. Okay, how to construct the table and record the initial reading for activity 2 is here. So we need to put initial burette reading, initial burette reading, all right, and a volume of acid obtained. This is will be final, this is final burette reading, all right, and the calculation. Okay, always start with a chemical equation. Use the formula for titration, MaVa over MbVb, NaNb. This Na is number of mole of acid, which is 1 mole. This is number of mole of alkali, which is, okay, 2 mole. So I apply here, I try to get the answer 0.1 mole, okay, per cubic decimeter, negative 3. And state the observation for the change in color. Okay, of indicator. So activity 1, they use phenolphthalein. If they use phenolphthalein, pink solution turns to colorless. And the next one, they use methyl orange. The activity 2, they use methyl orange. The methyl orange yellow turns to orange color. All right, and we try to do the prediction. Okay, if the activity is repeated by replacing hydrochloric acid with same concentration of ethanoic acid, predict the volume of ethanoic acid needed to reach end point. It should be more than 25 cm³, or you can put exact value 25.05 range to 50 cubic centimeter. All right, the type of state the variables in this activity, type of acid use, the volume of responding variable will be the volume of acid to neutralize the sodium hydroxide solution, or the color change of the indicator, and constant will be concentration and volume of sodium hydroxide. Hypothesis will be if different type of acid to neutralize. If use different type of acid to neutralize the 25 cm³ of 0.1 mole Dm-3 sodium hydroxide solution, the volume of acid also will be different. Alright, operational definition, what observed plus what done. Pink solution, color solution turns colorless when acid from burette is added into mixture of what? Alkali and phenolphthalein solution. And now we need to classify the following acid into strong acid and weak acid. Nitric acid, HNO3, this is strong acid. Ethanoic acid, CH3COOH, this is a weak acid. Ascorbic acid is obtained from vitamin C, is used as antioxidant. Okay, prevent the oxidation of food, okay, by oxygen in the air. And this ascorbic acid is an organic acid and also is a weak acid. phosphoric acid, H3PO4, also a weak acid. So this is weak acid, this is weak acid. Only one nitric acid is a strong acid. Don't give symbol, try to write in full word form. Alright, so we already checked me. And my next prediction will be electrical conductivity of ionic and covalent compound in molten state. Again, the electrolyte will be put on air place or into crucible, and we will place carbon electrode. We check the deflection of ammeter reading and we try to get the reading. If let's say ionic compound, the substance made up of ionic compound, the ions in the molten state or aqueous state able to move freely and carry the electrical charges, and therefore we will see the ammeter needles deflects and shows the reading. So here, the when we start to read this substance P, okay, substance P, there's a deflection, so we get the value of 0.2. this is ionic. Okay, here remains unchanged 0, 0, so this is covalent. Okay, so here the reading is 0.5, this is ionic, and this is 0.0, this is covalent compound. Covalent compound, therefore S and Q is a covalent compound. Alright, so how to construct a table and record all the reading? So we have a substance P, Q, R, S, 0.2, 0.0, 0.5, 0.6, and please put unit here. Alright, next to the title. In this experiment, the variables will be manipulated variable, type of compound, compound, or we can put compound P, Q, R, and S. Alright, the responding variable will be ammeter reading or electrical conductivity of the compound. Constant variable, we use carbon electrode. One hypothesis in this experiment, ionic compound conduct electricity more in molten state, whereas covalent compound cannot conduct electricity in molten state. Alright. Okay, based on diagram 1, state 1 observation, in when substance P and substance R is added, the needle of ammeter deflects and shows reading. So substance P and R is here, P and R. Okay, substance P and R shows the reading. So therefore, the observation will be the ammeter needle deflects and show readings. All right. Okay, we go for inference. So inference for the answer, P and Q is an organic ionic compound. They are freely moving ions and able to conduct electricity. And explain why the needle of ammeter is not deflect for substance Q and S. Why is that it does not deflect? So here you see substance Q is here, S is here, it remains unchanged. The substance Q and substance S exist as molecules. There is no freely moving ions to conduct electricity. Alright, state operational definition for electrical conductivity. When two carbon electrode deep into substance P and substance R, this is what done. The heated, the needle of the ammeter deflect is what observed. Okay, and the last question, does the needle of ammeter deflect if the experiment repeated with lead 2 bromide? Okay, and acetamide and naphthalene, they are in molten state. Lead 2 bromide PbBr2. PbBr2, when in the molten state, heated, they will produce lead 2 ion and bromide ion. The electrostatic force will be overcome and they form freely moving ions and able to conduct electricity. Acetamide and naphthalene is a covalent compound. Okay, naphthalene will be C10H8. Okay, they exist as molecule. There is no freely moving ions to conduct electricity. Alright, we check question number. It's the next question. Investigate the effects of temperature on rate of reaction. And here is the reading. Students required to put the reading. If let's say here I don't have a S, so we need to put the time second. Alright, check the answer. Okay. So I'll go for how to construct a table and record the initial temperature, time, and 1 over T. This 1 over T represent rate of reaction, right? And we need to plot the graph. The plotting the graph is very important. Must come out with title, a graph of temperature against time, and must come out with with a label on axis Y, label on axis X, and we should plot the graph. We should use X mark, X symbol like this, and we should draw in this well, in this way, all right. Okay, we go for next question. Okay, based on the graph, state the relationship between the rate of friction and temperature. The temperature, the higher the temperature, the higher the rate of friction. Or as the temperature increases, the rate of friction increases. Alright, the manipulated variable, the temperature of sodium thiosulfate, rate of friction will be corresponding variable. Volume and concentration of hydrochloric acid will be the constant variable. And the operational definition will be the time taken is what observed. The time is what observed. And the X mark disappear from the site is what done. Alright. Okay. Can. Okay. We go for next one. The effects of catalyst on the rate of reaction. So answer is given. Please check. Alright. This is the diagram given to you. Alright. Okay. 50 cm power 3 of 0.1 mole Na- 3 of hydrochloric acid reacted. Here they put magnesium. So set 1. Hydrochloric acid react with magnesium. Okay, you will get MgCl2 plus H2. Balance the equation, put here. Okay, put 2 in front of hydrochloric acid. And set 2, they repeated. Okay, so here we check set 1. Okay, so if they repeated this in this reaction, we can add catalyst. The name of the catalyst, copper 2 sulfate solution. We need to add 10 drop of copper 2 sulfate solution. And students required to do table and record the data like this. And manipulated variable will be presence of catalyst or copper 2 sulfate solution. Responding variable will be rate of friction, volume of concentration, and concentration of hydrochloric acid will be the constant variable. Hypothesis: when catalyst present or when copper 2 sulfate solution is present, the rate of friction is higher. All right. Okay, and the observation in this experiment, colorless gas bubbles given off at 60 second temper time. Alright, the corresponding inference will be hydrogen gas is given off, okay, or is produced. Alright, so we need to draw the graph. So I draw the graph here. Okay, so this is the expected graph. So we must use X symbol and we try to draw the graph. Alright. Okay, and the next one, check the next question, must have title, must have a unit for axis X and axis Y. All right, okay, and we checked sketch the curve obtained for set 2 on the same axis. So the set 2 with the rate of reaction with the presence of catalyst. So this is the set 2. Okay, the rate of reaction will be faster, higher. All right, the time taken is shorter. All right, any question, let me know in the comments, so I will reply to your question. All right, based on set 1, state how the mass of reaction of mixture change with the time. The mass of the reaction mixture decreases with time and remain constant at 120 second. If we see the graph, 120 second here, the mass remains unchanged. All right. Okay. We go for next question. State the operational definition for this reaction. So the change in the mass of reaction that is measured, okay, at 60 second interval. Referring to the graph, how do the rate of reaction in set 1 and set 2 differ? Give a reason. The rate of reaction of set 2 is higher than set 1. This is the, okay, this is the one we observe from the graph. And the reason will be the gradient of a graph in set 2 is higher than the, okay, than the set 1. It's more steeper. Alright, the presence of catalyst, copper 2 sulfate solution in set 2, the graph in set 2 is more steeper. Alright, okay, and we try to check how to classify. Okay, the chemicals equation for the reaction in set 1 and set 2, okay, can be write as follow. Okay, they want classify elements and compound. Okay, when magnesium will be under element, okay, is present exists, the particles exist as atom. Alright, and hydrochloric acid will be compound. Okay, and compound exists as ions. Okay, magnesium chloride will be under compound, exists as ion. Hydrogen K gas will be under hydrogen, a gas will be under element exists as molecules. So the answer will be like this. All right. Okay. We go for next question. Okay, next will be design. Our targeted question for design and experiment. I will start with a highly targeted one. Okay, so we go for this one, this question. All right, to investigate the concentration of electrolyte affect the product form at anode during electrolysis process. And look at the conversation between the two students. Okay, so my electrolysis produce chlorine gas. Another student state the mine electrolysis produce oxygen gas. And if let's say we take one substance like dilute sodium chloride solution. Okay, we have total ions present in the dilute sodium chloride solution will be sodium ion, chloride ion, hydrogen ion, hydroxide ion, 4 ion. I try to arrange anode, place the ion at anode is a positive terminal, cathode will be negative terminal. I arrange element according to the position, their position in ECS, sodium ion and hydrogen ion. And when dilute and when they use carbon electrode, always remember anode factor 1. Alright, anode factor 1 and pilih bawah, you have to choose the bottom one, and the cathode always at the bottom one, and hydroxide ion always remember to put 4 hydroxide ion, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, so when we put your electrode, the electron will be donated, 1 electron, 2 electron, okay, 3 electron, 4 electron. So 4 hydroxide ion, they donated, they loses 4 electron. Now they become a neutral molecule, they will collide each other. This one break, go here, break, go here. You get 2 water molecules. So I'll put here 2H2O, then this one will bonded together form oxygen. So the product get is oxygen for this student. All right, if let's say I try to repeat this experiment by using concentrated sodium chloride. The formula of the ions will be sodium ion, chloride ion, hydrogen ion, hydroxide ion. So I'll move the ion to anode, which is positive terminal, cathode negative terminal. I place the ion according to their position in ECS. All right. Okay, sodium ion, hydrogen ion. Okay, cool. So now we try to check which ion will be selectively chosen to be discharged at anode. If factor 2, which is concentration factor, anode always remember pilih atas. Alright. Cathode always pilih bawah. Alright. Cathode always bawah. So anode atas. So anode, the name of the product or the half equation 2 chloride ion will produce chlorine gas plus 2 electron. This gas is known as greenish yellow. Yellow color gas will be given off at anode. And always remember, student must remember factor 1 and factor 2. Alright, factor 1 and factor 2. We must draw electrolytic cell. Alright, only for factor 3 we can draw a beaker. Factor 1 and factor 2, we must draw electrolytic cell. We must use carbon electrode or platinum electrode, which is inert, must have switch. Alright, switch. Okay, so which one is anode? The carbon electrode that connected to the positive terminal of the battery, this is anode. Anode, we must place a test tube to collect the gas. So this is the experiment setup that we should remember in order to obtain the materials and also the apparatus. All right. Okay, and I'll try to answer this question. So try to check the aim of this experiment. The aim of this experiment is known as to investigate the concentration. So this concentration will be manipulated variable. Concentration of electrolyte affect the product form at anode. So the product form at anode will be our responding variable. Our constant variable will be during electrolysis process, we will use carbon electrode. Okay, so how to answer problem statement? So problem statement will be, does the concentration does the concentration of, I guess, does the concentration of sodium chloride solution, we take one example, concentration of sodium chloride solution affect the product form at anode during electrolysis process. During electrolysis process, then we must put question mark. All right. Okay. We go for problem variables. The manipulated variable in this experiment will be concentration of sodium chloride solution, and the fixed responding variable will be product form at anode during electrolysis process. The constant variable will be carbon electrode, right? Okay, the hypothesis, when the higher concentration of sodium chloride solution is used, okay, chlorine gas or chlorine molecules, okay, chlorine gas is produced at anode. When lower concentration of sodium chloride solution is used, okay, so we will obtain oxygen gas produced at anode. The apparatus is battery, carbon electrode, connecting wire, electrolytic cell, switch. Concentrated sodium chloride solution, dilute sodium chloride solution, dilute sodium chloride, and wooden splinter. And we can put here one more is blue litmus paper to test the presence of chlorine gas. All right. Okay. Our procedure. Okay. We pour dilute sodium chloride solution into an electrolytic cell more than half full. Then next point, invert test tube filled with sodium chloride solution at anode of carbon. Turn on the switch to complete the circuit. Okay, so we check. Next will be observe and record. Observe and test the gas released at anode. We oxygen gas we test with glowing wooden splinter, and chlorine gas we will put moist blue litmus paper. It will turn to red color. And next point of step number four will be record all the observation at anode. Last step will be repeat step one until step four using concentrated sodium chloride solution to replace dilute sodium chloride solution. And the last point will be tabulation of data. So here we put manipulated variable with the unit mole DM -3 observation. We can put dilute, concentrated, or with the value. All right, so here the value will be 1.0 mole DM -3. All right. Okay, so this is the ionic targeted question for SPM, and the next targeted question for SPM will be coagulation of latex. Okay, try to check this question. Diagram 2 shows the fresh latex produced from the rubber tree and a coagulated latex transformed into rubber cover or rubber strip. Referring to the diagram, plan a laboratory experiment to investigate the effects we change to effect. Of acid and alkali will be manipulated variable. The coagulation of latex will be responding variable. The latex, which is volume or temperature of latex, will be the constant variable. All right, we try to answer this question together. Okay, the problem statement for this experiment will be, does acid and alkali affect on the coagulation of latex? So this will be, does acid and alkali, okay, affect on the coagulation of latex? All right, latex. So I'll put a question mark here. All right, so there I already obtained 3 marks. And manipulated variable will be type of solution added to latex. All right, or we can put straight away, can name the solution added. To coagulate the latex, we need ethanoic acid. To prevent the coagulation of latex, we need ammonia solution. So in this experiment, we will pour 50 to 100 cm cubic centimeter. So I'll use 50 cm power 3 of latex solution. So I'll pour, measure and pour 5 cm power 3 of ethanoic acid. So I can see then we must take a glass rod. We stir the mixture by using glass rod and I can see the latex can coagulate. Alright, so now then it will turn into strip. Alright, so you repeat, if when we repeat the same process, latex 50 cm power 3, we pour ammonia solution. Okay, ammonia solution and we stir the mixture, we can see the mixture still remain in the liquid form. So this is ammonia solution. Prevent the coagulation of latex. Alright, so we try to do the responding variable. The responding variable will be coagulation of latex, and constant variable will be volume and temperature of the latex. And now we try to go for hypothesis will be when ethanoic acid is added to latex, the coagulation occur, and when ammonia solution is added to latex, it prevent the latex from coagulating. So we need beaker, glass rod, measuring cylinder, latex, ammonia, ethanoic acid, ammonia solution. All right so we do what? We measure and pour 50 cm power 3 of latex into a beaker, right? Then we add 5 cm power 3 of ethanoic acid into the same beaker. The mixture is stirred. Stir the mixture with glass rod. Observe and record the changes that occur to the latex. Repeat step 1 until step 4 using ammonia solution to replace ethanoic acid solution. The last part will be tabulation of data. Under tabulation of data, I try to write type of solution added into the latex. Alright, so here I add latex plus ethanoic acid. Here will be latex plus ammonia solution. All right and we check the observation. So this will be our responding variable, this will be manipulated variable. Okay, cool. Okay, so now we go for the next observation, experiment, targeted design experiment, elasticity of vulcanized rubble. Okay, if student want the module, please subscribe my channel and message in the comment box. I will send the module to the students. All right so we go for third observation, when Suraj. So this is factor 1 and factor 3. Okay, under electrolysis process, the type of electrode affect the product form at anode. And we go for fourth targeted question, to investigate the number of carbon atoms per molecules of alcohol, effects on the heat of combustion. Okay, and the next one will be investigate the position of carbon in the reactivity series of metal, and the last one will be to investigate the reactivity of metals towards oxygen. Alright, so always remember, tomorrow never dies, always for us. I wish our best wishes to all my students in SPM. I will come out with another slot for paper 2 and one more slot for paper 3. So thank you very much guys, always remember, tomorrow never die. Take care, bye bye, see you.